Hello, I'm Peter Fiduccia from the Woods and Water TV series. We've been doing the Woods and Water series for over 30 years now, and it's seen on the Hunt Channel, it's seen on Wild TV, YouTube, and also Netflix. Today we're going to talk a little bit about planting food plots. And one of the questions I get all the time on food plots is, what type of plants can I put in that will actually be able to attract and hold deer during the hunting season? Well, there aren't any real plants that you can actually guarantee holding deer on your property, but there sure are some that will keep them coming on a much more regular basis. And the plants that I recommend are two. One, actually three. One is called brassicas, and that includes the family of forage rape, forage kale, canola, turnips. On another angle, a sugar beet seed is also good. Then there are the clovers, and the problem with clovers is that most people plant warm season clovers. If you're looking to have deer in your plots during mid-October right through December, then you want to look for the cold weather or cold season clovers, and they include cura, copa, a lot of the red clovers like marathon clover, some of the white clovers, and of course chicory. Chicory is one of the prime seeds that I recommend people put in their food plots because it's a plant that not only attracts deer, has a lot of nutrition for them. With the brassicas, these are plants that you put in around mid-August. You can plant them a little earlier if you want to get a little more leaf growth, a little more tonnage out of the plant. But whenever you plant any of these things, it's very smart to wait until you know you're going to have rain within 24 to 36, 48 hours. That really sets the plant off and helps it germinate much more quickly. Although a lot of people say that you can throw and grow, that's not really a good kind of a plan to get a good hardy crop. What you want to do is always make sure that your seeds have good seed to soil contact. You don't have to disturb the weed bed too much by tilling. I'm an anti-tilling type food plot planter. I like to put my seeds as maybe a quarter inch under the soil. I scratch the surface with my tiller. I put the seed down with a hand seed a lot of times because it spreads it a lot nicer. And then I wait for a time when I'm going to do that, when it rains. If you're going to use a herbicide, one of the best herbicides you can use is called Big and Tough. And Big and Tough serves two purposes. It kills broadleafs and it kills grass. And that's basically what you need to do when you're using a herbicide. The directions will say wait 10 days before you plant. Over 30 years of doing this, I can tell you that I wait about 5 or 6 days and then I plant, and it really helps. When you wait that 10 or 11 or 12 days to plant, lots of times you'll wind up getting a lot of weeds that'll start coming up along with your plant. So plant it around 5 or 6 days after you used your herbicide. Some of the seeds, as you can see here, are very tiny. And these seeds are brassicas. Like the clovers, they're tiny seeds. So you really don't have to worry about the turkey and the birds and the crows picking them up and eating them. Make sure that you get a good seed to soil contact with them. You can ride over with your vehicle, or you can ride slowly over the plot with it with an ATV. I don't normally do that. The best thing you can do, like I said earlier, is to wait for a rainfall. If you do it and it's going to rain within 24 hours to 48 hours, it's going to pack the seed down for you and it's going to help the germination tremendously. And that's a really, really good plan. Another seed that, or seeds that you might want to think about, are the small grains. I'm not a corn type planter. Corn is usually gone by mid-October. It doesn't do really much after that for the deer. So what I put in is sorghum, and sorghum is very similar to corn. And sorghum will grow tall like corn if you buy the tall variety. Don't buy the short variety. As a matter of fact, they like the tall variety better. I also put in a seed called triticale. Triticale is a hybrid, and it's a small grain. It's a hybrid of Sicale cereale, which is a winter rye, and it's and it also is a hybrid of winter wheat. Another good plant is winter rye, but you have to make sure that you're buying the small grain rye, not the grass rye. And all of those type of grains you plant the same way you plant the brassicas in late August or mid-August, and they'll come up right through. Around October, you'll start to see the field of green up, and then around November, you're going to see growth that's going to be several inches high, and by mid-November, sometimes it's 4 feet, 3 feet high, and the deer really love it. Its grains are really nutritious, and they seek them out heartily when it's cold season. All the plants that I just recommended are what I call winter hardy plants. And those plants are what any deer hunter who wants to have deer on their land eating those crops during hunting season should be planting, no matter where you are. They will tolerate temperatures down to 10 degrees and even lower. Some of them, like cura, and that's a clover, will tolerate extreme winter temperatures, and deer will dig them up right underneath the snow. If you're interested to get more information on food plots, my next book is called Shooter's Bible Guide to Food Plot Planting. It has everything I just mentioned here and much, much more in the book. It'll be out in this May, and you can order it on our website, which is deerdoctor.com. Any questions, feel free to email me, and I'm happy to give you some more information.